A surprising black hole giving birth to new stars rather than devouring them. Black holes, which are sometimes depicted as deadly monsters that devour light, take on a less evil role in the newest Hubble Space Telescope research. Black holes are some of the most intriguing objects in our universe and assumed to be violent monsters sucking in everything. But a recent study shows something very opposite of it. The study shows that instead of destroying and devouring stars, a black hole is creating them. How is this possible? What is causing this black hole to give birth to new stars? Today we're going to talk about a pretty interesting and somewhat unexpected discovery of what appears to be a supermassive black hole that instead of destroying stars and consuming matter, appears to be responsible for actually creating new stars and doing so extremely actively in this particular galaxy not too far away from us, which is something that has never really been seen before, despite the fact that certain theories in the past have proposed this. So let's talk a little more about this in detail. Also, you can find the research paper in the description below. And make sure to give a like to the video if you like it. A black hole in the dwarf galaxy Hennai's 210 is producing stars rather than devouring them. The black hole appears to be contributing to the galaxy's inferno of new star creation. The dwarf galaxy is located in the southern constellation Pyxis, 30 million light years distant. By carefully looking at the image, we can see some extremely bright features here and there. This is due to the fact that we are looking at a starburst galaxy, a galaxy recognized for having a large number of diverse star-forming areas and for having some really gorgeous characteristics all around the galaxy. Other current theories suggest that these starburst galaxies are typically the result of a galactic collision or massive galactic interaction in which a large amount of gas suddenly condenses in certain regions of the galaxy, resulting in very thick clouds that then produce various regions where stars form. This galaxy is also rather unique, as it is a form of starburst galaxy known as a wolf-rayet starburst galaxy. Wolf-rayet stars are extremely interesting and captivating. In essence, this depicts an incredibly busy region with vast quantities of gas generating many stars and extremely big, very, very large stars, comparable to what's happening in the adjacent Large Magellanic Cloud. Some of the most extreme stars, as well as some of the most massive, brightest, and active neighboring stars, are all found in the Tarantula Nebula, a portion of the huge Magellanic Cloud. This is very similar in the Tarantula Nebula, as it contains really huge active stars, some of them potentially hundreds of masses of the Sun. This is the same thing that is observed in the galaxy Hennai's 210, except that it is much farther away from us. Because of its modest size, scientists first assumed this was a nebula much closer to us when they found it, and it wasn't until the 1970s that scientists formally proved that this was a galaxy. However, because it was assumed to be a planetary nebula, it was given the designation Hennai's 210. Today we know that this is a galaxy, and a pretty interesting galaxy at that. In 2011, astronomers investigating this galaxy in greater detail discovered a relatively huge black hole within it. This little galaxy sparked a decade-long discussion among astronomers about whether dwarf galaxies had black holes equal to the supermassive behemoths observed in the centers of bigger galaxies. Little Hennai's 210, which has one-tenth the amount of stars contained in our Milky Way, is said to play a significant role in resolving the enigma of where supermassive black holes originated in the first place. The black hole was approximately 3 million masses of the Sun, which is surprisingly massive for such a small galaxy. It is somewhat similar in mass to the black hole in the center of our Milky Way, even though the Milky Way possesses approximately 10 times more stars. But of course, this is an exception, not the rule. We don't anticipate such big black holes to exist within these galaxies. So this is already quite a big mystery. This is very huge for a dwarf galaxy and a highly rare phenomenon. And the presence of such a large black hole in such a tiny galaxy shows that these black holes may have originated before the galaxies were even formed, which might explain the mysteries of its origins. But that's not exactly what we want to talk about today. Normally, we would anticipate these gigantic black holes to be in charge of, well, basically preventing star formation. This is referred to as quenching. Star quenching is when a massive black hole becomes active and stars devouring a star or a really massive cloud of matter starts to fall into the black hole and then forms a really large accretion disk, giving birth to really large outflows, astrophysical jets, as they are known to come from both sides of the black hole, resulting in massive consequences such as galactic winds, which travel over the whole galaxy, heating up the gas and inhibiting future star formation. This is the broad explanation for why many active galaxies cease producing stars and end up being relatively quiet for a long time until something else happens. For example, another galactic collision or some other disruption. But that's not what's happening in this galaxy at all. When this black hole became active, it produced the exact opposite impact. Star formation appears to have been caused by the actual streams emitted by the jets. That link is a gas outflow spanning across space like an umbilical cord to a brilliant star nursery. When the low-velocity outflow came, the region already had a thick cocoon of gas. According to Hubble Spectroscopy, the outflow was traveling at around 1 million miles per hour, striking into the thick gas and spreading out like a garden hose slamming into a mound of dirt. Hubble determined the ages of newborn star clusters that dot the route of the outflow's propagation. The Hubble images clearly show that the gas stretching in the galaxy is definitely produced by the black hole in the center, with scientists even comparing it to a kind of umbilical cord that appears to stretch from the black hole to the star-forming region, which is somewhat symbolic in a sense because it appears to be the only black hole we know of that is physically forming new stars through the emissions from its jets. Hennais 210 is only 30 million light-years distant, which is close enough for Hubble to clearly capture both photos and spectroscopic evidence of a black hole outflow. The outflow was also surprising in that rather than inhibiting star formation, it was causing new stars to develop. But how precisely is any of this occurring, and more crucially, why aren't we seeing it in other galaxies? Well, the explanation is most likely due to the power involved. Unlike other intense emissions, such as those from quasars or other extremely powerful galaxies with huge black holes at their centers, the power of the jets here is far lower. Even the material appears to be traveling much slower, and so all of this material coming from the black hole is most likely hitting this big, reasonably thick cloud that previously existed here at speeds of approximately 500 kilometers per second, rather than relativistic rates as would normally be the case. Also, the distance between the star-forming cluster and the black hole is approximately 230 light-years, implying that this is occurring somewhat further away from the black hole itself, possibly far enough away not to be affected by other things close to the black hole, but close enough and packed enough to remain as a single cloud and not fly apart. So because this particular black hole is not overly active or massive, and also because it did not produce these extremely powerful emission effects, all of this seems to imply that in some cases, rather than stopping star formation activity, some black holes, if the conditions are just right, actually create more stars. For now, this is the only galaxy we know of where this is happening, and it seems to be relatively rare, but chances are we're definitely going to be finding more of these, and more importantly, it might even help us understand a little bit more about our own galaxy and our own central black hole as well. For example, recently scientists definitely detected signals of star formation occurring not far from the Milky Way's core black hole Sagittarius A star, as well as indicators of fairly medium size or medium power activity from the central black hole. There might be some sort of connection which the scientists would want to explore, but the implications from this study are intriguing, and scientists are hoping to understand another mystery of our cosmos, supermassive black holes. The creation of supermassive black holes remain a mystery. We don't know if they began before matter solidified, potentially from some kind of primordial stuff that existed early in the universe, or if they developed from a group of early stars. Scientists believe that in the future, even more study will be devoted to dwarf galaxy black holes, with the goal of exploiting them as clues to the puzzle of how supermassive black holes formed in the early cosmos. Astronomers have been puzzled about it for a long time. The link between the galaxy's mass and its black hole can give hints. The black hole in Hennais 210 has a mass of around 1 million solar masses. Black holes in bigger galaxies can be more than a billion times the mass of our Sun. The core black hole grows in size as the host galaxy grows in size. There are three types of current ideas on the genesis of supermassive black holes. One, they formed in the implosion of stars, just like smaller stellar mass black holes, and somehow gathered enough material to grow supermassive. Two, special conditions in the early universe allowed for the formation of supermassive stars, which collapsed to form massive black hole seeds right away. Or three, the seeds of future supermassive black holes were born in dense star clusters, where the cluster's overall mass would have been enough to create them from gravitational collapse. So far, none of these black hole seeding ideas has emerged as the dominant one. Dwarf galaxies such as Hennais 210 provide interesting perspective clues since they have remained tiny across cosmic time, rather than growing and merging like giant galaxies like the Milky Way. Astronomers believe that dwarf galaxy black holes might be analogs for black holes in the early universe, when they were just forming and growing. But by studying more about this intriguing galaxy, scientists hope to find more about the origins of supermassive black holes and how they were formed. It's poetic that an extremely creative black hole that defies laws about how black holes are supposed to behave may actually aid scientists in unraveling the most ancient of galaxy mysteries. One thing is sure, that the future scientific discoveries will be something to keep your eyes fixed on. So what do you think about this strange black hole? How will this help us understand our origins? Let us know what you think in the comment section below. Also, make sure to like our video and subscribe to the channel, as it encourages us to keep making amazing videos like this for you. Thanks.